day. It is December 5th. It's currently 8:30, and I'm on my way to appeal this parking ticket that I got. So hear me out. I went to work on Saturday, and I parked my car, and I put coins in the first 2 hours, and then the next two, because I only worked a four-hour shift. The next 2 hours, I paid online. This is where I effed up. I paid online, but when I put my license plate in, I put my whole license plate in, but I accidentally put an L at the end, like the letter L. I come out from my shift and I see a ticket, and it says, and I quote, meter expired. Expired meter / not paid by phone or plate / paid wrong zone. So what I'm thinking is the person being petty not only said maybe you did pay, but you wrote your plate wrong. So I'm like, damn, like I did technically write my plate wrong, but sir, that's my plate. Like all I did was put an L by accident. Maybe because I'm a big loser, you know what I mean? I don't know where he's going. But anyway, so I'm on my way to appeal it right now. Hopefully I could appeal it. And if I lose the case, well, you know, lose the appeal or whatever, can you at least put it down? It was a $30 ticket. If that's the case, I could have paid for parking. Like, you know what I mean? Like, what? It just made me a little mad. So, I'm on my way to get that appealed. Hopefully, wish me all the best, because honestly, it's just crazy that it even had to get to that point. Like, what you mean $30? But hopefully, if anything, if I get there and if I don't get it fully cleared, make it a $10 ticket or something. Like, I feel like you gave me the maximum sentence. So that's what I'm doing. I'm running a little late because I want to be there for 8:30 actually. But that didn't happen. So yeah. Last week was kind of cute. Y'all know last week I went with my mom. This is crazy that we had a break like that. That's because that man wanted to be an a-hole. But anyway, last week, y'all know I went with my mom to her dinner. It was nice. I was annoyed at first, obviously. If y'all watched the video, you know. But I ended up finding out about the royal family and how President Biden was in the city. And I was like, oh, that's why I couldn't get there. Because when I tell you, it should have only took me 30 minutes. So how did it turn into an hour and a half? What? But anyway, the food was impeccable. It was so good. And everything. It was just, you know, the ambiance was nice. It was real nice. KQ. What else was I going to say to you guys? I was going to say something else. Yeah. And then I went to see my friends, because you know I don't usually vlog on Sundays. I try to use that as like a refresh day. Oh, this one I want to tell you guys. I saw my friends on Sunday, yesterday. I went to see my friend Becky's baby again. He's so cute. I can't believe he's about to be a month old. Ugh. And then my niece is also a month old, which I think is crazy too. And then I saw my friend Jocelyn. I haven't seen her so long. I mean, I've seen her at my housewarming, which is cool. But you know, you gotta keep in touch with your friends. I be trying to do better with like, be like, hey, like, I'm still here. You know, don't feel like there's any bad blood. I still love you guys. You know, because sometimes you get caught up in your own life that you forget. Like, shit. I'm sorry for swearing, but you get it. Like, it's like, dang. Like, I really love these people. So I'm trying to do better going into 2023 with like really like, you know, hanging out with my friends and the people that I care about, because, you know, life is so unexpected, whether that be like, you know, not even just death, you know what I mean? Like even hardships, any hardship really. So I'm just trying to be a better friend, you know, going into 2023. Also, I decided, like an impulsive B-I-T-C-H that I am, to start to pick up another side hustle. So on Saturday, after I got that ticket, I was like, you know what? I'm a DoorDash. Why? I decided to. And it wasn't bad. Like, I actually made decent money for the 3 hours I was out. I talked to my mom and I also talked to my boyfriend like pretty much the whole time and listened to some music, but it was pretty good. I feel like I'm gonna do it like every once in a while, like just to have that extra money in my pocket, you know what I mean? For the most part, I don't know if I'm gonna do it long term. I definitely just know I want to do it during these winter months, like holiday season months. And then I'm still contemplating on if I want to pick up another, like, because I was watching TikToks and other things, and I was told that pretty much with like DoorDash and stuff like that, you want to do more than one thing. So like if you do DoorDash, you want to do Instacart, or if you want to do Amazon Flex, or you want to do all these other. I hit a button and it turned off of the camera, but my bad. If you don't know what any of those things are that I just said, like Amazon Flex and whatever, you can simply look it up. I found out what Amazon Flex was. I didn't even know that was a thing, but whatever. I'm still trying to figure out if I just want to do simply DoorDash or if I want to do other like Instacart like things. Who knows? But like I said, I don't see myself doing long term. It's just a little extra money during the holiday season, because obviously it's gift giving. I just got a new apartment, so I didn't plan accordingly for gift giving and getting furniture. Like I was like, I'm so wrapped up on getting furniture, I'm like, oh yeah, it's holidays, I'm not gonna be that guy who doesn't gift give. And then I have like some gifts that I really wanna make them a very sentimental for some people, you know what I mean? So just a little extra cash don't hurt nobody. And especially when I got that ticket, I was like, oh, the government can throw out tickets just because I put one little L at the end of my license plate, then I can get some extra money, because that was petty. Like, I feel like, and the part that made it petty was because it says in the description, plate/paid wrong zone. So that means that you knew that there was a potential that was my license plate, and you still gave me the ticket. Like, dang, that's how you feel? I hope you get cold for Christmas. I'm kidding, but not really, but you know. So I'm on my way. I'll talk to y'all when I get there. I hope they clear it. I hope I get somebody who's real nice and was like, what, they was extra like that? Girl, Merry Christmas, like, you know. But we'll see. I'm just praying. All right, I'll talk to y'all when I'm there. I feel like I look crazy no matter how much I turn this camera. I feel crazy, but anyway, y'all, I'm back. It's way later in the day. When I talked to you guys, it was like 9 a.m. It is officially like 2:30 in the afternoon. But anyway, let me just give you guys a little story time. So when I got there, right, I was like, hey, like, I'm here to appeal a ticket. The woman was like, you have to go down the street for that. So I go down the street or whatever. And after that, the woman at the front desk goes, oh, sorry. The woman at the front desk goes, what are you here for? I was like, oh, to pay. No, she said, are you here to pay a ticket or pay like payment or something? I was like, no, I'm here to appeal it. She goes, okay. And she was on her computer. She gives me this paper. Mind you, I had this whole skit ready. I have my tears ready so that I can tell a sob story and stuff like that, because I was going to tell them, like, I didn't know that I accidentally put that L at the end. Like, I've been struggling. You know, the only reason why I was there is for a job. I had this whole spiel so I can get out of this ticket, because I don't feel like paying it. So finally she just gives me the paper. So now I'm just looking like, dang, I have no one to give these waterworks to. Like, I'm sitting here ready to prepare to, you know, find a way out of this ticket. Finally, I write down everything, and then on the description part, I was like, I give them the transaction number, like, and I told them I did pay for it, and I told them exactly what happened. But I was just telling them, yeah, I'm struggling, I barely can make ends meet. Like, I was, bro, whatever I could, I said in there so I could get rid of this ticket. I know some of y'all are like, girl, you should have never forced it like that, but it be like that. Do you know how long, like, no. Like, I don't know how else to explain it. Like, no, I don't feel like paying this ticket. So long story short, I was talking to the woman and I gave her my paper. She's like, you're finished. But at first it was awkward because she forgot that she gave me her pen. So I put her pen down, and then she was like, thank you, like, you're all set. But then I just decided I'm gonna give somebody these fucking, stop swearing, Aaliyah. I'm gonna give somebody these, you know, teardrops or whatever I was trying to do, you know, the sob story. So I was like, yeah, like, and my, I've used my soft voice this whole time to the point where this woman can't really hear me. I was trying to make it seem like I was mad soft spoken and shy. This woman was like, what did you say? I was like, yeah, like, can you walk me through the process? Like, how long does appeal take? She had the audacity to look me dead in my eyes and be like, appeal takes 6 to 8 weeks. Now I'm thinking, I'm at this drive-thru, so give me 1 second. I'm thinking, like, hold up. 6 to 8 weeks, that means I could tack on extra stuff. Hi, how are you? Can I get the... I'm going to take the famous bowl meal.
Famous bowl meal, that's $9.09 with the side order and a drink.
All right, for the side order, can I have mac and cheese, please? And then can I have the sweet lightning Mountain Dew?
Sure, would you like anything else?
Yes, and then can I also get how many sides come in the in number 8, the 3-piece chicken?
3-piece, original, crispy, 2 sides.
It comes with 2 sides?
Yes.
All right, I'll do that then.
Original crispy.
Original's fine.
And what would you like for your 2 sides?
One will be fries and the other one will be mac and cheese.
Fries and mac and cheese?
Yep, fries, and then the other one's mac and cheese.
So mac and cheese or mashed potato?
Mac and cheese.
Sure, and your drink?
And then the drink will be a fruit punch.
Sure, would you like anything else?
That would be all.
Last window, please.
Thank you. But anyway, I'm not gonna put this window all the way up because she just said last window. But yeah, so she was like, yeah, it takes 6 to 8 weeks. And then so I was like, so what happens then? She goes, the woman's going to read your letter and then she's gonna decide if she approves or not. But like, you're gonna accumulate fees obviously because it's 6 to 8 weeks and you should have paid it a long time ago. So she goes, if I get approved, then they'll... Hi, how are you? I'm good, thank you. How much is it? I forgot how much it was. How much? $22.83. $22. Okay. Thank you. Your nails look nice. What's this? No. A Mountain Dew Sweet Lightning? And then is this a fruit punch? Which one's the Sweet Lightning? Okay. This ain't my order. Thank you, love. And is this a regular Mountain Dew or is this a Sweet Lightning one?
Regular.
You have the Sweet Lightning one today or no? All right, thank you. And then the other one's a fruit punch, right? The other drink?
One Mountain Dew, the Sweet Lightning, and one fruit punch?
Yes, yeah. I accidentally, yeah. Make sure now. All right, cool. They got the food right. Thank you so much for your patience. Have a great one. Happy holidays. Because I was about to say, I'm like, what is she handing me? Like, but anyway, she's like, yeah, the woman could... decide whether or not she approves it. Just FYI, like, you're gonna get fees. Like, she told me that straight up, like, you're gonna get fees and then the ticket's gonna increase. Don't worry about it, because if she does approve your appeal, it would be dismissed. But if she doesn't, we could put you on payment plan. That's when I was like, who the fuck wanna be on no payment plan or something? I think she said payment plan. I feel like that's what she said because that didn't make sense to me. Long story short, I'm looking at her like, well, I basically told her, like, hey, I already paid this parking meter. All I did was actually put the wrong, like, I put an L at the end. Like, I told the story, like, 8 times. She's like, well, truthfully, from, like, past experience, she feels like the woman will let me, like, be all set. Right? She'll let me be all set, but she will probably tell me in the letter. Mind you, she's going to email me this letter. That's another thing that I was like, okay, email me the letter. She's going to tell me in the email, like, push come to shove, basically, make sure next time you write your license plate right. Because if you look at if you look at my transaction, I did pay for it. I just accidentally put that dumb L at the end. But I'm just annoyed because it takes this long. I've never done an appeal. I usually just cough it up and pay the ticket. But no, especially since I actually paid, no. But we'll see. It just makes me a little skeptical during DoorDashes, because if I already have a ticket, I don't want any more tickets. Y'all ain't about to put a boot on my car. I don't want that smoke. So, I don't know. We'll see. My lips look mad dry. Yeah, I did some DoorDashing this morning, like early in the morning after. Not early in the morning, like right after I left there, I did some DoorDashing. Then I went to my mom's house, actually. I went to my mom's house to get some work done for my 9-to-5. And now I am hungry and on my way to do some more DoorDashing. You know, gotta make money as much as I can. I'm only doing this now because I promise you, when I'm 67 or whatever the age limit is, I promise you I ain't doing this no more. And that's just that on that. I'm not doing this no more. Whether I have the money or not, I will be retiring. I'm manifesting right now. But yeah. Alright, I'm gonna eat this while I drive, even though that's like mad unsafe, but I'm starving. And I'll talk to y'all later. And just like that, it's Tuesday. I think it is December 6th or so. It's currently roughly like 1:05. And don't mind me, I'm doing laundry right now, so whatever. Yeah, earlier today I was doing a few DoorDashing deliveries. It wasn't bad, had to make a quick buck or two. And then at 1:45, I have a meeting with my manager just to talk about, like, you know, like my goals with the company, what my KPIs are looking like and things of that nature. Nothing crazy, just like a usual one-on-one that we usually have. But guess what, guys? I want to tell you, I've been looking at the package room for like days now, and my other wig is finally here. I'm so happy that it finally came. At least that's what I think it is. I didn't buy anything else. It feels like a box. So, all right, guys, my camera did something weird and it cut out. But I just want to let you guys know, this is my second wig from You Nice Hair. So I bought two wigs. One I'm wearing on my head, and this is the other one I bought. And then you guys know that I bought, well, I didn't buy, they gifted me this one. So this one was a gift. At first I was confused, like, did they mess up my order and give me two of the same wigs? This one's a gift. And like I said, I'm going to do another video. I'm probably going to do a video for all three of these hairs just so I can have some more content. It's nothing crazy. I'll probably just talk with you guys and stuff like that. I want it to be as interactive as possible. So when you guys see this video, definitely comment like topics you want to talk about or things that you think will be interesting so that I can make that content later. But right now I'm going to do some more laundry, as you can see, and then I'm going to do some work and then I'll see you guys after this one-on-one. Good morning! Today is Wednesday. Whoa, no. Today is Thursday. I didn't even record Wednesday because I went in the office yesterday. Because I just felt like the gift of giving needed to happen. So I gave everybody who was in the office a little cute little thank you for, you know, your hard work card. And I try to personalize it for each and every person. And that, a little bit of chocolates. There's a few people who are in the office that don't... Yeah, you can tell I just sprayed the water and just left it there. Sorry. There's a few people in the office that I don't know personally, like on a personal level to really make it personable. That's the tech. Yeah. Like, we have a, like a, not a cubicle, but like a cube, like, we have a row of offices only specialized for tech, but since they're all the way hooked in the corner, I don't really get to talk to them on the day-to-day, but I still gave them something because at the end of the day, nobody's work is big or small. Like, we all come together to make a bigger effort. So I wanted them to know that I appreciate them. Not, you know, yeah, I don't know how to explain it, but yeah, I wanted everyone to know that I appreciate them. I mainly did it for my, you know, I'm just checking the length to make sure that my wig ain't shedding that much. I mainly wanted to do it for my team, like the team that I'm on. But when I got there, there's a few people in the office, and I want them to know that they're appreciated too. Like, we might not talk on the day to day like that, but your efforts do not go unnoticed. That's exactly what I wanted to portray. So that's what I did yesterday. Work was not bad, actually. It was very productive. I guess that's why people go in the office. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm productive whether I'm in the office or not. That's one thing I have to do, because I'm a go-getter. Like, I gotta get this money. So, you know, I got bills to pay, so I try to be on top of things for sure. Also, you know how I thought my meeting with my manager was on Tuesday? It was Wednesday. I messed my whole self up. So for the rest of the day on Tuesday, I just DoorDash. Oh, speaking of that, I haven't talked to y'all in a minute. Why DoorDash try to play me? So right after I found out that my meeting wasn't for Tuesday, I don't know why my lips been doing that lately. Like, that's so ugly. I don't like that. You know, that crust look. Am I putting too much on? I don't like that at all. Okay, that's a little better. So, after I figured out that my meeting wasn't for a Tuesday, I went ahead and DoorDash pretty much all day, because honestly, it's real easy. If you never DoorDash as a driver, this is how it goes. It will find your location. First of all, it'll show you all the places in the particular city that you're in the surrounding neighborhoods. What's busy, what's not busy, whatever. I'm a top dasher, so that means that even though it's not busy in my particular area or zone, they're still going to try to shift me. I'm going to say shift me leads, because I don't know how to explain it. Shift me gigs, or give me gigs. So, yesterday I was in a hot spot though. What a hot spot is that place is so busy because they have so many orders that they'll give you a peak pay. Your peak pay can go anywhere from $1 to, I've seen almost $5 before. So imagine your base pay plus tips and then $5. Honestly, it's not that much money, to be honest. Like, don't think, oh, I'm getting $25 every time I pick up an order. No, unless you do one of those big orders, which I don't usually do. I like to keep it very small, and I don't like driving too much. So if I drive, it has to be like a bing, 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 not like a over here, over here, over here. No, keep it cute, right there in the order. So long story short, where I was able, it was a small condensed area, so I was making like quick little money. And then once I signed off for the day, I get an email saying your DoorDash account has been deactivated. And I'm like, what do you mean it's been deactivated? And then I scroll down and it says your DoorDash account has been deactivated due to suspicion of fraud. So now I'm like, what you mean I ain't me? And then so all I could do was appeal it, because they're like, oh, I thought there was something on me. They were like, you can't call us. Like, even if you do call us, there's nothing they can do about it. You just have to appeal it. So I appealed it, but my raggedy ass still called, because what you mean I can't talk to a customer service rep? because this is crazy. Oh, not to mention, the reason why I was so pressed about my account being deactivated is because it states when your account is deactivated, the money that you made, you don't get it. So I was like, wait, I haven't cashed out the money that I made, because if you cash it out daily, it's $1.99 fee, which I don't mind, but you have to be doing DoorDash for 2 weeks, and I've only been doing it for a few days, so I can't cash out anyway. So I was like, what you mean I can't get the money that I worked for? You know what I mean? So I called the customer service rep, and she told me the same thing. She told me, girl, I told her the situation already. I was like, hey, my account has been deactivated for fraud. I already appealed it, but can you explain to me why it's been deactivated for fraud? This girl puts me on a brief hold, 5 minutes or something, and comes back and was like, yeah, Miss Jackson, your account, yeah, it's been canceled for fraud. I was like, I just told you that. I literally just told you that. And I was like, why though? She goes, I have no idea. I'm like, there's no notes. So I'm just deactivated for fun. Like that, I didn't say that to her, but I'm like, you can give me more. Like, if you're gonna tell me I'm fraud, tell me why you think that. Long story short, I'm trying to think about what I wanted to say. Oh, long story short, she just puts a note in my account saying like, hey, I called and that I'm concerned. She said something. I didn't care at that point because she told me she couldn't fix my account. So finally, the whole day goes by and stuff like that. And I'm just like Instacarting. And the reason why I'm doing all the extra jobs is just so I can have quick money. Like, you know what I mean? Like, my money could go to bills and all the other stuff. Also, furniture, you know, like, I've been buying a lot of furniture lately. So, I want some more pocket money, to be truthful. Like, I don't need it, but, like, it's nice to have. So, I'm grateful that I'm in a point in my life where I don't actually need to depend on it. But, I digress. Anyway, so I just started Instacarting because they said if you get to 10 batches, you get an additional, like, bonus. So I got to 10 batches, got the bonus, went about my day, forgot, this was yesterday, forgot about it, you know. I'm just thanking my coworkers for their time and efforts and, you know, appreciating all that they do. Then finally I get a bling. So I look at my phone. Your account has been reactivated. I was like, that's what I'm talking about. Because another thing that annoyed me was because they told me it would take 10 days. She told me, and I quote, it would take you 10 days to get your money. I was like, what do you mean it would take me 10 days to get my money? Like, with DoorDash, you're supposed to get paid like every week. But when I started, I couldn't get paid the first time around because obviously they're trying to figure out if I'm a real person or not or whatever they're trying to figure out. So I was supposed to get, basically I was going to get paid this Monday coming. And she was basically like, no, you're going to get paid in 10 days. Because she basically made it seem like I was not getting my account. And I was just like, damn, I just drove. I mean, don't, like I said, I don't drive crazy like all these crazy places. I would have been more mad if I did that. But I still drove. Like, I still did some deliveries. But I'm just happy about that got reactivated. I'm just blabbing at y'all. So that got reactivated. And then I do Instacart on the side. Honestly, I don't know which one I like better, to be honest. Because with Instacart, I do it. Whoa, why am I stuttering? With Instacart, I do it in places like Chestnut Hill. I did it in Burlington
before. Sorry about that. My alarm went off. But I was saying I've done DoorDashes in Burlington before because when I went into the office, it was close to my job. Like, literally. So, yeah. So, I've done that. And those places are really pretty. Burlington, Belmont. I don't know. I'm trying to figure it out. I feel like that's the area that I was in. I think I was in Belmont. because I don't know. But anyway, I just saw some pretty houses when I was Instacart, and I was like, dang, they're mad pretty. And also with DoorDash, they put you on some hidden gems. That's what I like about it. I like that. So I just found out about a lot of good food places in Cambridge. Yeah, Cambridge. Where else? Cambridge. I just found some good food places. Like, I would definitely, when I pick up people's orders, I'm like, oh, I might have to eat here. Like, that looked good. So, yeah. Other than that, I'm just on my way to pick up my grandmother. She wants me to take her to Sears. Sears. So, she needs a winter coat. I might record her and see how she act, because that woman's hilarious. That woman is hilarious. If you don't know her, you should know her, because she's an amazing soul. But she should be in comedy, because she's fucking hilarious. Yeah. I have a spray bottle that I can spray some of this hair. I slept with it on, but the thing is, I put, see this side? Because I sprayed some water on it, but it looks like only this one section got it. Like, this one's still poofy. I know, don't come at me. I didn't do my edges or my leave out this morning. I just got up and went because I have no more gel. So on my way to get my grandmother, I'm gonna get some gel as well. And then, yeah. And we're gonna have a beautiful day. That's all I can really say. So I'll see y'all soon. Hopefully my cocoon is a little bit more tame. I don't think I want to say cocoon. I want to say bird's nest. I hope my bird's nest is a little more tamed, and I'll talk to y'all soon.
Come with me, leave all of your things, yeah. You can stop at Gucci, stop at Louis V, yeah. Come with me, fly you out to Greece, full speed, so volé Paris, yeah. Come with me, leave all of your things, yeah. You can stop at Gucci, stop at Louis V, yeah. Come with me, fly you out to Greece, full speed, so volé Paris. Speedboats, baby, in Nikki Beach, waves in my ears, smoking
weed. Good morning, it's Friday. Happy Friday. Yeah. Sorry, it was all over the place. But anyway, I want to show you guys a few things I got at the mall yesterday. BRB. I went to Macy's with Nana. She got herself a few cute little items. We might have to go back because Macy's does this thing. Like, if you have a credit card, which my dad does, you can get like star rewards. We didn't use his credit card. We just racked up the information. So, like, basically his credit card has an account attached to it. So all we did was put all our items in there so he can get those cash, like the star rewards. And yeah, we got $80 worth of star rewards because we was spending so much money. But long story short, back to Nana. She got herself a coat, some tights, a shirt. Me and her are going to my little cousin's birthday party. She's officially 1 year old. She's so sweet, so beautiful. So I'm excited for that. It's at Coco Keys. I don't know why Nana's coming. First of all, I've never seen my grandmother go in the water, let alone have a bathing suit. But she wanted to come, so we're gonna go. It's on Sunday. I don't usually, like I said, I don't usually vlog on Sundays, but we'll see. Anyway. So we got a few things for her, but about me. So we got this cute little bodysuit. It's nice and thick. Let me show you where it's from. Alfina. I got it in a size large. I haven't tried it on. I was kind of skeptical of if I wanted a large or an extra large, but I saw the extra large and it looked like it was like more for like your stomach. Don't get me wrong, I have a stomach, so I should have probably went with the extra large, but I did want this very tight and form fitting, so I got in a large. I found it on like the rack that looks like people tried it on. I'm scared to like put this on right away, so I'm gonna probably wash it first. It doesn't have no stains or anything, but I don't trust people. Sorry, not sorry. Let's see. I'm just putting that right there. I got this because I don't know why I got this. I just did this for, I don't know. I just bought it because I have a lot of girdles and shapewear, but like when you put on the shapewear, your back part right here, it still be fattening. It be showing through. So I bought this. It's a size large. Look at the arms. My arms are huge. I don't know if my arms are gonna fit it. Like I sat there in the store and I stretched it. It got nice stretch and it got nice hold. So I'm gonna try this on with the dress or something to see if it really does get rid of right here, that problem area I have right now. But I got in a size large. Also, it's gonna give me like a little boob lift. Not a little, it's gonna be a lot actually. But I got that. And last but not least, I got this. I got this cute little puffer Guess crop jacket. Now, my grandma was originally looking at me like, girl, don't buy that. It don't fit you. It don't fit you. I'm like, Nana, it does fit me. She goes, no, look at it. It's so small. Like, because it's right at my boobs. Like, literally, the person who worked there had to intervene and be like, no, ma'am, she's right. Like, if that woman didn't intervene, my grandma would look at me crazy, like, because it's all the way up here. But isn't she cute? Like, do you have a black puffer even? Are you from New York even? I'm kidding, but yeah, like, I thought it was cute. Just, well, yeah, just a little something. And I can tell it fits because look, it's right on my arms and I could do this, like, are you from New York even? What? Mm-hmm. So yeah, I really like it. I like it a lot. It looks cute. Just something so I can wear out when I'm like, you know, doing something cute. Like, you know, like a little dinner, like or something, like up here. And just what the back, you get the vision. But yeah, so that's the three things that I got. Nothing crazy. After we went to, why am I, like, I'm always out of it when I record. Like, I act like I don't talk to you guys often enough to know what I want to say. But anyway, after we went to the mall, I went and got something to eat from McDonald's. I know, but it was good. I got a Big Mac because I downloaded the app, and here's why I downloaded the app. For T-Mobile Tuesday, they gave us a free chicken nugget, so I had to download the app in order to get my free chicken nugget. And then when I looked at the app, you can get so much stuff for cheap. Like, I got a Big Mac with a medium fry and a medium drink for $6. Like, usually that's like at least $10. So I saved $4, but if you eat at McDonald's often, I feel like that adds up, you know what I mean? But long story short, I just got something to eat, then I came home, I had a meeting, did that meeting, got some work done, and then I picked my cousin up from the airport. She went to, I think, Jacksonville, Florida. She went to Florida, I don't know where in Florida, but she said she enjoyed herself, and that was good. And then, yeah, my day, that was it. I haven't been to the gym all week, which I'm kind of bummed about because it's just like, Aaliyah, we need to get in the gym. I'm trying to take off this nail because it's lifting. I'm sorry. Okay, I did. I didn't mean to flip y'all off. It's just that the nail, it was hurting me. But yeah, so I didn't go to the gym. I would like to go to the gym one of these days. I took the weekend off from work. So, yeah. Yeah. I have this weekend off. I'm going to see my friend Marley. I think I told you guys this before in one of my previous vlogs, but I'm going to see my friend Marley. It's a surprise. Her birthday was last week, and me and my friend Osasia are going to go and pop up to see her. I can't wait to see that reaction, because I told her on her birthday, I was like, hey, what's your address so I can send you a gift? I am the gift. You know? I'm kidding. I might bring her a little something, nothing crazy, but yeah.
So that's pretty much how my day is looking like tomorrow. But today, I'm getting my eyebrows done. I have my appointment at 11. I'm getting them laminated. I don't know if I told you guys that, but basically I'm getting an eyebrow perm. That's the easiest way to say it. I'm gonna get my eyebrows permed and I'm gonna get them. I want them tinted just a little bit so it can fill in some of these like gap areas. Last time I went, she was like, girl, don't do it, but I'm gonna do it. So I'm gonna get my eyebrows laminated. I hope I like it. I'm with the tint. I got my eyebrows tinted before and I hated it. Why am I doing it again? Because this is a different woman. The one who did my lamination and the one who did the tint are two different people. And I like the way this girl did my lamination, so I trust that she'll do my tint good. Because the other woman, she just tinted my whole lash. I was like, I have dark lashes already. On top of that, I didn't even like the way she waxed my eyebrows. But that's another story. But anyway, she tinted my whole eyebrow, but I think a hybrid would be good for me. So that means like this part will still be me and the rest will be a little bit darker. I think that's what I want. So I picked a hybrid tint with lamination. So that appointment is at 11 and it's in Malden, so I have to drive there. So I'm trying to get myself like maybe an hour. I don't need an hour, but I want to give myself at least an hour. Yeah, that's pretty much it. And I'm going to just record while I get my eyebrows laminated. And yeah, I'll see you shortly.
Okay, y'all. I'm a little early, so I'm going to go to this Dunkin' that's right here to get something to eat. So, yeah. I'm in the drive-thru. Hopefully, it doesn't take too long. I also need to find parking. That's one thing that like sucks about coming out this way is finding parking. The last few times I went to her, I was able to find parking surprisingly, but I also went like later in the day. So I need to find parking in a little bit, but I'm hungry. Is it where I'm gonna go? Exactly. I think I really wanted to get McDonald's breakfast because I've been really feeling, I know that sounds so bad to say, like, Aaliyah, you should be more healthier, you shouldn't be eating McDonald's, but that steak, egg and cheese on a plain bagel, yeah, like that's all I can really say is yeah, like it's really good. In the meantime, while I wait, I'm gonna take a piece of gum just to, I don't know, calm my nerves. I don't know. I'm just chatting at this point. But yeah, I do hope I find parking. I really do hope because, and if I find parking, I want it to be close. I don't want to really walk. You know what I mean? I don't feel like walking. Not that I'm having a camera right here. I've never seen that with a Dunkin' drive-thru. There's a whole ass camera. I'm sorry for swearing. A whole camera sitting right here on the thing. Hi, how are you? Thank you. I'm good. Can I have a turkey sausage, egg, and cheese on an English muffin?
Turkey sausage against an English muffin?
Mm-hmm. And then I'll take an order of hash browns. Yes.
Okay.
Do you have hot chocolate? Like,
yeah,
can I have a small one?
Hot chocolate?
Yeah, can I have whipped cream on that?
Yeah.
That's all.
Okay, thank you.
I know that sounded dumb, like Aaliyah, of course they have hot chocolate, but like I didn't know how to explain it. Like, sometimes they have hot chocolate, but the machine be weird, and you know, and especially because I used to work at Dunkin', like sometimes like you need to clean the machines every couple of days. So it was a valid question in my opinion. So don't judge me for that. I'm also excited about this lash appointment because my lashes, especially this one, already look nice. So hopefully I enjoy her just shaping them up, laminating them, and tinting them a little bit. Because this one's given. Yeah, I didn't show y'all my card. So, don't come at me. It's on the back. Haha. Anyway, yeah, this part is just whatever. But this is given. KQ. My hair's still a little wet. Just a little. Like, this part's dry, but right in here is wet. But I needed to brush my hair because my hair looked like a bird's nest yesterday. I looked horrible yesterday. You know? Yeah. Is that a pimple? A pimple's forming? You see it? Oh. Yeah. Even though I should have started maybe this week, next Monday, I'm going to start my Vlogmas. Because, you know, Christmas is coming up. So I'm going to start my Vlogmas thing. Yay. That was awkward. They weren't ready. Hi, how are you? Thank you. Now I have to find parking. Thank you. All right, no worries. When she said sorry originally, I thought she was gonna tell me my card declined. I was about to be like, girl, do that again. But she said sorry, one moment, please. I was about to say, I was like, my card declined? But yeah, oh, that looks so horrible. It's like a cluster of like pimples trying to form or something. Oh my gosh, not God. I love you, Jesus.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. I appreciate it. So yeah, now let's find this parking and yeah. I'm gonna let this man walk because I don't know where I wanna go. I'm gonna let him cross. Yeah, go ahead. Cause I have no idea where I wanna put this car. There's all these tow trucks that have taken them like 8 spots. That's why I don't like, sorry, you have like 8 spots right now. A spot right here. No. That sounded crazy. I feel like falling in love. That TikTok song is in my head, but it's the remix. Can someone please tell me, is that Poetic Justice, like the sound behind it? Now, this person's kind of a dickhead because they took up 2 spots. I hope this truck is leaving. Is this tow truck leaving? Yay, because I want to park right here. Thank you for leaving. Oh, sorry. I'm trying to get this parking spot. So, yeah. Oh, never mind. Thank you. He's not gonna let me have this parking spot. Yay. I wanna find parking. Jeez Louise. Find parking. Let me go around. Let me go around the parking spot. Are you not leaving? I want this parking spot. I don't want to walk this far though. That's the thing. That's the real thing. Yeah. All right, sister girl, I feel you. She was doing like a U-turn. I'm like, sorry, girl, I'm in your way. But I also feel. Let me see. Luckily, I'm still early, but it's just like, let's hurry up and find a parking spot because I need one. I'm gonna go down this street because the other one says do not enter and I need to find a way back. I feel like falling in love. I'm so off. That sounded crazy. I don't know what street I'm on, but let's try to hope that it's close. I just try to do a big old U-turn. That's pretty much what I try to do. Let's see if I successfully did it. I did. And we love that for me. I see that car. I'm gonna let y'all know I'm coming out because I can't see y'all. So let's try that again. I need a parking spot. Find me a parking spot, y'all. I feel like falling in love. Let me go right here. It looked like I could park there. Let me see something. I feel like falling out of love. Let me move out these people's way. I don't know what I want to do here. Okay. I figured out what I wanted to do. I don't know if I could finesse, but I'm gonna try to finesse this spot right here. Keyword try to finesse. If I broke none of my business. And it's 2-hour parking, so we can always try to finesse this. I feel like I could. It's looking promising. I kind of came into here a little too tight. But that's just me. Finesse that a little bit better. Okay, perfect. That's better. Ooh, y'all. I kind of fucked up. Of course I fucked up. I need to do this like a whole lot better. And I'm gonna let him go so I can get into this better. Let me pretend like I know how to drive. Like I know how to drive. Okay, thank you. Have some common sense, girl. I feel like falling in love. I got in it though, so that's all that matters. Oh, I'm like in it, damn. I'm in this shit mad nice. Yay. We love that for me. And I'm gonna sit here and I have 2 hours. So, well, I have 2-hour parking. I don't have 2 hours to sit here. And eat, but I'm going to eat a little bit I'm happy. I found a parking spot. And it's across the street. No crazy walking. Yeah. We love that for me. I haven't had McDonald's. See, McDonald's is on my mind. McDonald's, I'm gonna need you to relax. I haven't had Dunkin' Donuts hash browns in years. Like, these are okay. Like, in other words, what I'm trying to say is I like them, like, super crispy. These are soft and crispy. More on the soft side, but I like them. It's not bad. Not bad at all. I didn't get my nails done, but whatever. Let's try this hot chocolate, though. Because sometimes the hot chocolate be watery and extra. Girl, I don't see not one bit of whipped cream on here. What happened to my whipped cream? Now, would I be ignorant or be not ignorant, would, but I'll definitely be that guy if I go in there and be like, yo, where's my whipped cream? Do I want to be a bitch? Do I want to do that today? And it's good though, but it would, you know, whipped cream just puts the icing on the cake. I really don't want to be that guy though. I'm gonna just be good. It's the season of being thankful. I'm thankful that they didn't even mess up the order. You know what I mean? I'm thankful that they saved me a couple of calories. So I'm not even gonna do it. It's a good thing that there's no whipped cream on there. I saved me a few calories I need to get rid of anyway. I had to make sure my thing was locked. Oh, that's funny. And then the people behind me are leaving too, so somebody else gets a parking spot. Her hair is mad pretty. I don't know if y'all can see it, the blue hair in the passenger seat. That's mad cute. Okay, girl. Mad cute. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Also, this girl that I'm going to, she has expanded since. So she's always been in this particular salon suites, but now she has a bigger space. So I might like vlog it a little bit. Now my hand's looking ashy. What the hell? So yeah. The person behind me is super lucky. As long as you don't hit me, though. Like, she's super lucky. She just swooped right in. All right. I'm going to finish eating. And then you're going to see me get my eyebrows done shortly. But I'll see y'all literally in a few minutes. Like, literally. Don't even worry. All right, y'all, so I'm back. This is how it looks. Ew, what is that? I'm so sorry. Ew. But this is how it looks. They look really nice to me. The first time I got them done, I'll probably put it over here. The reason why I like it is because the arch looks really nice. So this is how it looked when I first got them. Dark, like tinted. And I didn't love it. It looks very dark, but that's okay. It's gonna lighten over time. But the actual shape of my eyebrows, yeah, like it looks good. Like I like the shape. I like the shape better. Like she did what she had to do. I originally went in there for lamination, but she only waxed my eyebrows and put the tint on. She didn't realize that I was going in for lamination. So long story short, she gave me one of her soap brows. She said this lasts like all the time. So I'll put her information probably right here on the screen. You guys, if you're from Boston or Malden or wherever, come check her out. She's dope as fuck. And I've been to her a few times, so I really like going to her. Actually, funny fact, she's the first person to give me my Brazilian wax before. And she's super nice. She makes you feel very comfortable. So if you guys do go to her, please go to her. Like, she's really nice. So I say all that to say, I'm about to go back. All right, I'm gonna put my seatbelt on. I'm about to go back to my house and get ready for this meeting I have at 12. After that, I'm gonna get some work done because my manager did ask me to get some things in by end of day today. And then after that, it's game time. I can do whatever I want. I can pretty much chill out. So we're just gonna do that. And I'll talk to you later. Okay, bye. I'm officially home now, but tell me why there was a detour on my route. And I went and I pulled down the window to speak to the officer, because one thing I noticed, especially when it comes to construction, they don't give you a detour route no more. And where I needed to go was on the street that they were working on. So I pulled down my window. Instead of the officer walking close to me, like, or trying to see what's wrong, he goes, "What do you want? Bitch, if you don't get your ass over here and act nicely," like, that pissed me off. No, like, mad rude. But anyway, he eventually comes over. I'm like, "Hey, like, I want to get on that street. Like, how would I get there?" Then he finally eased up, and then he smiled and said, "Happy holidays." But keep it cute. Don't try me, little Oompa Loompa. I'll knock your lights out. Anyway, back to me being content in my lovely self. I am going to clean up around here. I'm just trying to make it more home-like. I think I'm going to... I don't have a Christmas tree yet, so I'm going to look at some Christmas trees. I have an idea of what Christmas tree I want, so I'm going to get that. As you can see, I have those random pillows. That one needs a larger insert, so I'm going to be buying that insert right now. And I'm going to just get my house more feeling like a house. I'm going to look for a TV console because I want a TV console so I can... Because right now, it's mad ghetto. It's sitting on some of my boxes. I need my TV on a TV console before I mount it on the wall. So that's pretty much my life right now. I'm going to get myself together so I can just feel more ready for the holidays. Because, like, my house looks cute and all, but it's not holiday ready yet. So, yeah. Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take care of it and get it ready. Yeah.
I almost forgot to mention, y'all, I like them. And for those who are my close friends on Instagram, I've gotten my eyebrows tinted before and I hated them. Like, this looks way better to me. Even though it's still a little bit too dark for my liking, especially like around here, I know that this is gonna fade. Like, I see the potential in these eyebrows. And on top of that, they look symmetric. They look like they at least sisters. You know what I mean? But anyway, that's not why I decided to turn on my camera. I decided to turn on my camera because my Amazon package already came in. Sorry, I already opened it. I bought two of these. They're for the tissues. So one's for my kitchen and one's for in the bathroom. So let me just open it just so I can show y'all. My keys, but I have no finger. Well, I have a finger, but I have no... Yeah, y'all get it. So I bought these, and I will link them below just in case you want them. Excuse me. You can drill these into your cabinet or wherever you're gonna put it. I rent, so I'm not doing that. But the good thing about these is it has the sticky adhesive at the back. I pull it off and obviously stick it. For this, I want to put it like, so my cabinet, pretend like this is my cabinet, and I'll put it here so that you can just get it like that. So it'll be under my cabinet. Also, with my cabinets in my kitchen, I want to go to IKEA, I think. Maybe Amazon. I don't know which one I like better, IKEA or Amazon. Because I saw that you could put lights under your cabinet, rechargeable lights, so I don't have to waste electricity. I like that aesthetic, too. Like, that, you know, what am I trying to say? what kind of, not spotlight, what is that called when you have like, you get what I'm trying to say. I like that aesthetic. I don't know what I'm trying to say to y'all, but if you know, you know. So I'm going to put this one in the bathroom and then I'm gonna put the other one in the kitchen and I'll show you guys what I did shortly. So I just put it. I don't know how I feel about it. I might put something up here, like a wooden basket, and put little things in there. I don't know, but it's up there. I have the black, and the black. Hopefully I like it. I wish I could have this black, but it's like, it's on there, you know what I mean? So just, I like it. It's gonna have to grow on me. Yeah, but that's the whole aesthetic, is you just plop it on, under it, and then, yeah. This one, I pushed it back a little further than the one in the bathroom, and the reason being is because in a good and perfect world, I would have lights here, here, and then in front of here, actually, so that when I turn off the light and this light's on, you can, it will still show that I have lights right here. Hopefully it sounded good in my mind, so hopefully what I'm envisioning would work out, because I didn't want to put it right dead in the center, and then I know I'm gonna want a light right here, like that's inevitable, and I knew I was gonna want lights here too. So yeah, I just put it right there, and then that way I'll have lights just around here, not like the LED strip lights, but you'll see when I buy them. I have to buy them first and install them so that you guys can get an idea so that this doesn't look crazy. And another thing I forgot to tell you guys, I don't know if I said in this vlog or the last vlog, oops, sorry, about the turkey bone, the wishbone, the wishing bone or whatever, but I got the long side, so I was able to be the one to make the wish. So obviously I'm not going to tell you guys because it won't come true, but I just wanted to give you guys an update that me and my boyfriend did it last night, and I got the long side. Good morning, guys. I'm running late. My friend Osasia, she's in the car. Yeah, I'm using the comb. I don't know where my stoolie is and I don't got time. But I just want to show you guys an update on my eyebrows. This one feels lighter than this one. But now on camera, this looks lighter than that one. But yeah, they got lighter. They get light over time. But my eyebrows look bomb. Yeah, I had to get this cocoon done. And I washed my hair, blow dried it, left the part out. Like, I did the whole thing all over again. So if it looks nicer than normal, that's why. Because the first time I installed it, I just threw it on my head. I had things to do. I'm just cleaning out the sink because I have so much hair in the sink right now. But I just wanted to tell you guys, I'm going to surprise my friend Marley. She doesn't know that we're coming. So it's gonna be interesting. I text her like, hey, like I got something coming to your house with your address. And then I told her like, hey, are you gonna be home today? Cause it's estimated to be here today. So that's what I did. So yeah, I hope she likes her gift. I'm gonna go to the store and get her a little birthday cake on our way there. Just cleaning the mirror real quick cause the mirror looks filthy. So yeah, I'm gonna go and get a cute little cake, nothing crazy, and maybe some wine. And then we'll just go and head out. I want to show you guys my outfit because I felt cute. This is from American Eagle. I could post it somewhere. It's like a sweater dress, and it has like the sleeves go out. Like that's intentional. And then the bottom goes out. I have on, this is from Zara, right? Yes, this is from Zara. And then I have on my cute little mini Uggs, the Bailey ones with the bow. And then I have on this mixed with a few other perfumes right now. And then my essentials, you know. I didn't feel like doing my, should I do my edges? I'll do them in the car, but we're on our way. I'll talk to you guys when I'm there. Back home, it's a lot later than when I went to my friend's house. When I went to my friend's house, I got home around like, probably like 5:30 or so. But I'm getting ready to go to a housewarming. My boyfriend's friend is having a housewarming. He just got his own place. So I'm just trying to get myself ready. Now, I got this top right here, and I got these bottoms. I might pull this up so I can just look a little bit more cinch. But I don't know if I want to wear... I'm wearing a bra, but I don't know if I want to wear the black one. I got these from, I want to say Mad Rags, for like 10 bucks. But they do the strappy thing, and this is how it looks on me. Just so it can look like, you know, I'm skinny when I'm not. Yeah. I like these pants because they like have these little tassels here so that I can cinch my waist. I was gonna wear my Yeezys, but I don't know if I'm gonna wear this top. Should I wear a black top? Like, how does this one look? And I've gained weight, obviously, so don't come at me, but... I just wanna be comfortable. I'm trying to think. I'm also gonna do my makeup and stuff. I feel like we'll just stick with this color. I'll bring this one just in case, but whatever. I'm wearing my usual. See, I spray some in my hair, so just in case. Spray some on the shirt. I like to layer. So I'm pretending like I'm rushing. I'm not pretending. I feel like because I have to go pick up my boyfriend at his place, and then we'll go. He's all the way out in Lynn, which I'm like, why do you have friends out there? I'm kidding. I'm totally kidding, by the way. But he got friends all over. His other friends, he was gonna hang out with them because originally the guy canceled it. I never met him. This will be my first time. And so he was gonna go to the studio with his friends. Yeah, I know. Don't come at me. My man's not the rapper. He's not a SoundCloud rapper or any of that. You get it. But he's gonna go to studio with his friend. His friend makes music. He's a singer, actually, not a rapper. So put some respect on his name. I'm gonna use some of my Fenty. I'm obsessed with this, y'all. I am obsessed with this. Like, it just feels so good. And lately, I've been using a little bit of baby oil. I have the shea and cocoa butter baby oil. So I put a little bit of this, and it eats every time. Damn, I didn't mean to slap myself like that. I didn't mean to slap myself. But yeah. You know, just in case I want to show a little mid-drift, I got some, you know, get these elbows real good. I don't need nobody talking smack about me, you know what I mean? Yeah. But yeah, no, I really like this. It feels so good to me. I like it a lot. All right. So now that we got that going, let me put this candle out. Okay, I just did that. My hair is a little like, not blending on the side that much. Like, if I play with it and mess with it, you will really notice, but I'm gonna leave it alone. I'm gonna put my mid ring on, so I'm gonna put it on. I have like this midi ring. Is that doing too much? Should I put it on that one? Maybe I should put it on this finger, you know, because that's almost like as if it fits. So I might just do. That looks dumb. Never mind. I used to wear the mid finger right here, but these fingers, this ring, I used to wear here or here. So that's why it's like, never mind. You know what I mean? All right, so I put that on. Today was a productive day, because even though I went to go see my friend for most of the day, I got like so much done. Like, I got the trash out. I put away my laundry. Yeah, like, I got a few things done. I've been wanting to really put on the Gucci Flora for for a while, so I might just put it on. I have more than enough perfume on, but the more the better. Oh. And if you don't know, now you know. Okay. So these are all the way tightened. All right. I'm going to put on my Yeezys. That's what I'm going to wear. They're the most comfortable sneaker I have. I don't know who all is going to be there. So I hope I don't make a mistake putting on my Yeezys. Because it's a housewarming. But then again, this housewarming is starting at... It supposedly started at 7, but black people, I'm going to say 8. What would y'all do? I mean, it's not like y'all could tell me, but... I might have to throw on some Uggs. One thing about me, I'm putting on an Ugg baby. Yeah. And my shirt's a little see-through. I don't care. I'm going to be with my boyfriend anyway, so... I don't care. Like... He'll be fine. He'll take care of me. I'm gonna do my makeup and stuff, and I'll see y'all later. Bye.
All right, y'all. So I didn't put on makeup yet. Well, I haven't put on makeup at all. I have makeup just in case if I want to do, like, because, you know, I've got a little dark marks if I want to, like, color correct, but I don't think I want to put on full-on makeup tonight. I just did my edges for the first time in forever, and they look so cute and fluffy. I just like how they look. So I'm going to go pick up my man. And we're going to get something to eat because I called him. This is how you know color people. And I ain't even mad at it. He going to go, it's actually not going to start until 10 p.m. I was like, and you want me to drive out to Lynn? Okay. So when we going home? I thought my lip gloss was doing that, like, yeah, like that drippy drip look. But anyway, like, when we going home? My eyebrows look too good. I'm just saying, y'all better go to my sis. I'm going to have a link below. Y'all better stop playing with her. But anyhow, I'm going to go see my man. He always makes me feel good about myself. So if he tells me, because I'm going to ask him, I'm like, hey, babe, like, should I put makeup on? If he tell me no, which I feel like he would, I'm not going to do it unless I want to. I haven't put makeup on in a while. I haven't had the real urge to, other than when I went to my mom's. The roads may be slippery. Got it. It may be icy out here because I'm icy, wifey. Haters want to fight me. But yeah, let me put the seatbelt on because safety's first. Click it or ticket. I used to tell that to my parents all the time. Click it or ticket, mommy. Click it or ticket. I used to tell it to my dad more because he would never put on his seatbelt. Like, sir, like, put on the seatbelt. Like, he would obviously, like, click it behind him. But I'm like, put it on, like, for me. If you ain't gonna do it for yourself, do it for me. But anyway. This jacket's so cute, right? I'm finally wearing it for the first time. My bra's a little too tight. And it's like cutting into my skin, like the straps. I might have to have my boyfriend loosen it. But, yeah, so I'm on my way to go get him real quick. I want to eat something. But the thing is, I haven't been craving, but I've been wanting Chinese food. But me and my family have a tradition that every year we have Chinese food on New Year's. Like New Year's Eve, bringing in the new year. So I kind of don't want to break that right now because I do that with myself. Like after Thanksgiving, between Thanksgiving all the way until New Year's, I tell myself you can't eat Chinese food because what's the point of eating it when you're about to eat it for the new year? Like, so yeah, that's that on that. I can't believe it's snowing. Like yesterday was like 70 degrees and now it's snowing. Like, that's the part I don't understand. But yeah, but I'm excited. Not next week, I think. Is the next week the 18th? I'm gonna have to double check. But my baby Lonnie's coming home. He's finally come home from North Carolina.
I mean, don't get me wrong. Like, I want to go down to North Carolina one of these days to see him. But I'm just glad that he's coming home. Like, babes, I miss you. Like, I miss you a lot, honey boo. So, if you're watching this, yeah, I miss you, boo. I can't wait for you to see. Well, I can't wait to see you and for you to see the apartment and see, you know, all the stuff that's going on in life, you know. Catch up, you know, kiki. So, yeah, I'm excited to see him. What else was I going to say to you guys? Yeah, just a lot going on. Not a lot, but, like, a few things, like, at once, which it's not... I don't mean it in a bad way. I'm just saying, like, there's moving parts right now, and it's exciting because usually nothing really... I don't really do much, so it's exciting that I was able to see my friend today. And then, like I said, like, Lonnie's coming up to Boston soon. And then I'm going to my baby cousin's birthday tomorrow. It's just a great vibe. Like, just having things to do. Yeah, my Christmas tree should hopefully be coming well before Christmas Eve, but it said that if you buy your Christmas tree before the 11th, you'll guarantee to get it by Christmas Eve the latest. But I'm hoping it comes sooner so I can decorate it, because I have to put gifts under the tree so it can look pretty. But the only people I'm getting gifts for is, like, my immediate, like, small family. Sorry, y'all. Because I don't know what to get y'all. Truthfully, I don't know what to get y'all at all. Prayers, thoughts, and hugs. Like, prayers and thoughts, and yeah, you get it. So, yeah. Well, I like this time of the year. I like it a lot. My feet are kind of cold. Remember what the... It's cold on my feet. I still don't know what I want to eat. I know I said Chinese food, like, is off the table. I don't want to eat fast food. I don't even know if there's going to be food there. I don't know if we should come empty-handed. Like, I had a bottle at home, but, like, should I get them their own bottle? Mind you, the bottle I have at home is not open, so just give me a heads up. So, yeah, so don't be like, Aaliyah, what you mean you got a bottle at home? So, yeah. I have a bottle at home, but I didn't bring it because it's tequila, but, like, you know how people be funny about their tequilas. So I didn't want to bring tequila and people didn't like the one that I have. But I'm going to stop chatting and let y'all go because that's my boyfriend calling me now. So I want to see where he's at to make sure he knows I'm on my way. Catch y'all.